Whenever you're ready, you can go ahead and begin.
When I think of pitching in an intense or high-pressure situation, a lot of joy is brought to myself. I played baseball and pitched my whole life and want to be able to share what I know with you and others. Today, I will be showing how to fundamentally pitch. There are two ways you can start your windup, and I will show both in the speech. And I'm going to walk through how to feel comfortable and confident when you're pitching on the mound. I will also show what pitches I throw or what pitches you can throw in a game. See, when you approach the mound, it's very important to have your feet situated so you feel comfortable with yourself. And I will show you how to start a windup. This is just how I've learned or how I've been taught by my father. Now, if you're a left or a right-handed pitcher, you take one step back, take your right leg, and you turn it, and bring your left leg, bring it up, use your back leg to push off the mound to the catcher. Now, if you're a left-handed pitcher, it's just opposite. Take your right leg, just do the opposite. Now, I will show the second one, and it's called the stretch. It's a little different because there's one runners on base. So this is the mound, and you're watching your runners, you're looking to see where they are, you come set like this, and you can either lift your leg, or what I do is what's called the slide step, so it's easier, it's quicker to throw to home, I just slide and pitch. Now sometimes I will try to throw off runners, and I'll switch it up every now and then, and I'll do this, so try to get them to guess when to steal or not. And it is very important to feel as confident and as comfortable as you can when you're pitching. And showing confidence and actually doing it is half the battle. And trying to control the game as best as you can is what gives me confidence. And sometimes if I'm pitching in a fast pace, the batters will step out of the batter's box to try to give them more time or take a breather. What I will do is I act like I'm about to pitch. I'm getting all set, about to pitch. And I step off to kind of throw the momentum back to myself. But it's just really what's best for yourself and what feels most comfortable for you. Now, it is on to being able to throw certain pitches, just throw off batters and strike them out. And I will show you how to throw a four-seam. As you can look at your handout, you can see that you can hold it like this, which is four-seam, or there's different ways, like a two-seam, which is what I throw, and it's not a lot different, it's just a little bit more movement. The pitch, and I'll demonstrate how to throw. So I've taught, step back like this. Now, onto a changeup, which is on the handout. I throw like this, four fingers on my thumb, holding like this, as you can see. It's supposed to look like a fastball, and it comes in a little bit slower. It's supposed to be just a little bit slower pace than a fastball to throw off the batter. Now, a curveball, you can hold this many different ways, but I like to hold it. I like to hold it like this. But if you've ever seen or watched a pitcher, they hold it like this a lot of times, and they get a lot of spin on it. But when I throw it like this because that's how I've been taught, that's how I've learned how to throw it. Some people might call it a knuckle curve, but it's just a curveball to me. And I'll go from the stretch, like I said earlier, like there's runners on base, you're watching your base runners, come set, look once. Now, my favorite throw, just playing catch with someone, is a knuckleball. And you may think that you should actually pull with your knuckles, you do not. That's a very difficult throw. Sometimes I just pull it with my fingers, or my fingernails, and you can see right here. I'll demonstrate this one. So it's a little tough to throw sometimes. It's hard sometimes to control. That is one of my favorite pitches if I can actually hit it down. I've pitched and played baseball my whole entire life, and I hope I could teach you a thing or two about what I know. And knowing the fundamentals and is important to learning how to pitch and constantly having confidence is important, but not just for yourself, but to the batter so they know you're not afraid to pitch to them. But also being able to throw different pitches to throw the batter off and keep the batter guessing really helps. I hope this helps and will allow you to maybe go out and try baseball or want to pitch later in the future. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much.